Guys, you probably have this problem if you have a Cummins. I have some bad news and some good news. The bad news is there are many limitations to the normal fixed geometry turbo. The good news is there are easy ways to overcome these limitations. With a regular fixed geometry turbo, you're forced to pick the point in the RPM band that you want the turbo to operate best. If you want something that'll function on the top end and have decent power, like you get with a large turbo, you're going to sacrifice on the bottom end, which usually means it'll be slow to spool up, it'll be laggy. Or vice versa, if you want the bottom end to perform well and spool up fast, you'll have to go with a smaller turbo that sacrifices air on the top end, which equates to less power. So most of the time you end up sizing your turbo to perform somewhere in the mid-range, which means it doesn't operate great anywhere except for that one optimal point in the mid-range. That's the main drawback or limitation of a fixed geometry turbo. So even the best performance fixed geometry turbo is very limited and will only perform well at one optimal point. To make matters worse, for emission purposes, the OEM is now using tiny turbos with small piping, which restricts airflow, hurts performance and power, burns more fuel, and makes it run hot. Even the whole set VGT has a fixed stator position inside of it, and the vane is merely sliding open and closed so that the slot in the housing is merely getting bigger or smaller. They're not changing the angle of attack, they're only changing the pressure. Not to mention the OEM VGT turbos that come from the factory in both pickup trucks and semis are tiny and are equipped with embarrassingly small piping.
This is a good guess here. I can't get my calipers all the way in, but you're about 2.71 on the stock turbo. That's puny for a semi. That is puny. That's small. No wonder they run hot. Can't get enough cool air into it.
Now for the good news. The Turbonator INT is the easiest and best way to overcome the limitations of both the fixed geometry turbo and the stock VGT turbo. The Turbonator is made for performance applications and comes in many different S300 and S400, T3, T4, and T6 sizes. It is efficient, spools up fast, increases horsepower, and fuel mileage. The Turbonator has pivoting stators, or airfoils, that change the pressure in the turbine housing and guide the angle, volume, and velocity of exhaust gas flow. On the low end, or front end, when the RPMs are lower, the airfoils close more to restrict and guide exhaust flow. This develops higher exhaust pressure and directs it to the tip of the exhaust wheel, which makes the turbo wheel spool up faster. Then on the mid and high end, when the RPMs increase, the airfoils pivot open wider and redirect exhaust more towards the center portion of the wheel and allow for a higher volume, thus holding optimal pressure and speed to match the turbine wheel with the exhaust flow and power. The Turbonator is not actually changing the AR ratio, which is why it is not a variable geometry turbo. It just effectively changes the AR ratio. The S300 size Turbonator behaves like a 0.45 AR on the low end and a 1.1 AR ratio on the high end. The Turbonator is a great replacement turbo for most Cummins applications. It increases spool up time by 2 to 600 RPMs, improves horsepower by 10 to 15% without increasing the amount of fuel used, which means it improves fuel efficiency by about the same percentage as the power gain. It can also exhaust brake. It is the most innovative turbo on the market.